In this lesson, you'll learn how to find and relink missing media that Final Cut has misplaced, first by locating the file in the Finder and then relinking. The files can also be located with a spotlight search, and you can use NeoFinder to look for the files on your archive disks. We only need to relink media within the library, and then that affects both the event and the project. So what I'd like to do now is look at this media here, and it's obviously still connected. What we do know is that this media is inside the test event, which is inside the one test library. If we were to right-click on any of these clips now, let's click on this one, right-click, and reveal in Finder, it's going to show us that file or that media file inside the Final Cut test event library. So there's the test library, there's the test event within that library. This folder is the original media folder. There's also transcoded media and render files, but we'll worry about those at a later date. So within the original media, we see this one clip here, and that's the one that we right-clicked on. In fact, you'll see that all of the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 media files are within the original. Just for this exercise, we're going to take this media file and we're going to put it somewhere else so that we're going to force Final Cut to lose connection with it. So if we drag that and simply pop that in our main edits, there it is there. And if we were to select back into Final Cut now, we can see that media file is missing, obviously, because we've moved it. So what we need to do from a relinking point of view, if this were to happen to you accidentally, or when you move files accidentally, first of all, you'd select on the event that you want to relink the files to, and we'll see here that Final Cut realizes there is a problem. It's put this little orange warning sign there on this event, and that's the same orange warning sign that you're seeing here and here. So on the event, go to the file menu and select relink files. And there is the missing file. That's the one that we're missing. We could see all files there, and that would show us everything, all the media in this event. But we're only interested in this point in relinking the missing one. And so we can select on that and then locate selected. We know where it is. It's in the main edit's hard disk, and that's where the file is there. Final Cut still thinks it at this location, so it's looking for it inside the library, test event, and there's the file. So that's where it thinks it is. This is where we know it is. So we select it here and select choose, and now it's gone from the list. So we can relink it, and bingo, it's back again. Now, I'm sure you're asking yourselves, what happens if you don't know where the file is located? Well, there are some things that we can do. We can use Spotlight, or we can go to our archive disks using our archive utility called NeoFinder. Let's just look at Spotlight as the first option and see how that handles it. If we take this file here, which is the same one we've been looking at, and reveal that in Finder, then we can see where that is in the Finder here. And let's now move that, and we will copy it to the desktop and then go back to the file here, and we will simply delete that so that when we come to Final Cut, the file is gone. Now, if we don't know where this file is, the name is still there. We can click on the name and copy it, Command C, or go to your Edit menu, Copy, and come to Spotlight and paste, Command V, the name into Spotlight. Now, there is a trick here. Final Cut, when it converts the files from the original file name and transcodes them into the date, it puts in the two colons. In Spotlight, or in the Finder, that is recorded with an underscore. So if we replace these two colons with an underscore now, there is that file on the hard disk. Now, that simply tells us where it is. If we now were to select that file and go to the command key, we can see that that file is on the desktop by clicking on the name here. Shows us it's on the desktop. So if we go to the desktop, we can then use that in the relinking process. Now that we know that the file is on the desktop, we can go to the library or the event, select on it, select relink files. There's the missing file. Now we know now that it's located on the desktop. So if we come to the desktop, there's the file. That's where Final Cut thought it was, but we know it's here. Choose that, relink the files, and there it's back again. So that covers the use of Spotlight. What happens if you've archived your files on archive disks? Now, I use an application called NeoFinder, and NeoFinder is able to record all of the files that I have on my hard disks, even though they're not actually physically connected. So it keeps a list. You can see that NeoFinder can see all of your files, all of your dated files. So all we need to do now is to paste in here the name of the file from Final Cut and do a search. Now, because it works the same way as Spotlight, it can't find that file because both of the colons are there. So if we remove the colons and type in an underscore for each of those, and then search, there's the file we're looking for. We can see that it's on the 3 terabyte hard disk, and it's in the Angela and Steve original media. So then we can attach that hard disk onto the computer again and copy that file either into a location within the library that we're working in and use the link to this original media. In the next session, we'll look at a project that was created in Final Cut 7. In Final Cut 7, we'll create an XML file, and then we'll import that XML file into Final Cut 10.